I'm going to show you guys my actual application, and it's very embarrassing for me to show you this, but I will do it.
Oh,
so cringe. Oh. This is one of the most cringe emails I've ever seen. Hey Medicos, this video is about my medicine story. So it's about how I discovered it as an option, why I fell in love with medicine, my two very embarrassing failed attempts at trying to get into medicine, and then finally my third successful attempt at getting into med. Also, if you want to cut ahead, just use the timestamps in the description below. So, if that sounds good, then let's roll the intro. Boom! I'm Medico Sel, I'm a final year medical student from Sydney, Australia. I also work as an assistant in medicine, which is a new type of job. I make weekly videos about life in medical school, all things healthcare. Also, I'm going to start doing videos about my side hustle businesses. So if that sounds fun and interesting, then make sure you subscribe. So the first question is, how did I fall in love with medicine? I think I need to start this by making an acknowledgement that probably should be made by more people generally, but essentially that I'm very privileged. I'm privileged in many facets of life. I'm privileged even to have had medicine presented to me as an option. So my mum did medicine in France and worked as a doctor in France. But also my sister did a Bachelor of Medical Science. So healthcare and medical things were always presented to me at quite a young age. So even while I was young, medicine was an option. Then I started growing up. I was 14-ish. I was in year 7 and I started watching on the TV with my mum the Gunther von Hagen's Anatomy for Beginners, and he would do body dissections. This creepy German dude with a steak knife would cut and remove the flesh of cadavers for education. Shortly after I started getting into those videos, my mum got me this textbook of colouring in anatomy for beginners, and I would colour in these pages with, you know, the neuroanatomy of the cranial nerves, and I would have no idea what, you know, the pons was or the medulla oblongata or whatever. But I would be colouring them in and I'd be picking up on the words. I didn't know what they did or anything. But I would start showing off to my friends, which, by the way, is not a very good way to make friends. Then high school progressed. I was a pretty good student. I got a couple of A's, but mostly B's and a couple of C's. And I remember in year 10, I wrote this absolutely 10 out of 10, mwah, beautiful essay. The essay was about how planes fly and how that was analogous to how birds would fly, and they had the high pressure under the wing and the low pressure above the wing, and it would tilt, and then that would create lift and the plane and the birds, and it was beautiful, and I articulated, and I got a C minus. And my science teacher, this is almost like out of a movie, and I think I'm probably remembering it wrong, but this is seriously how I remember it. I remember her putting the paper down and her saying, "I hope you don't want to be a scientist," and then moved on, and I was just so then I put my head down, I studied my bum off just to prove her wrong, and in high school, really surprisingly, I, you know, got okay grades, but I topped a class. I topped human biology. And through year 11 and 12, I topped human biology almost every semester. And I was just like, yeah, look at me, I'm bloody sick, I'm the best. So it really fueled a bit of arrogance. And so then I applied for medicine thinking that I was a guaranteed entry. So my first application to medicine was a disaster. I had this high amount of arrogance. Like, I was a nice kid. By the way, I talk about myself as a different person because I don't identify much with how I was back then. Because, you know, identity is complicated, it's fluid, it changes, it depends on who we're with, all that philosophical stuff. But anyway, identity is complicated. Moving on, I'm going to show you guys my actual application, and it's very embarrassing for me to show you this, but I will do it because I think it's going to be a very good lesson. And it's going to be a good lesson into drafts and getting other people to review your drafts, because I thought I was so good that I didn't need anyone else to review it. And I was kind of embarrassed, right? Because when you get someone else to review your draft, it really makes you feel vulnerable. And this is what I wrote. Here we go. This is the receipt of my application. Oh gosh, 2012, year 12. Just remember, I'm a different man now. Yeah, it's a little bit embarrassing. Okay, so these are the questions you have to answer. You obviously don't want too many typos, and I've already found a couple. So the big lesson here is make sure you send this as a draft to someone else. So some of the questions are, where did you attend primary school, secondary school? Favorite subjects, least favorite subjects? your interests, hobbies, and sports. Any special achievements? Languages other than English? So I could talk about the fact that I'm French, but look at all these typos. This is just disgusting. And also the formatting is bad. That's not capitalized. So little things like that make a big difference in applications. I would certainly not accept this application for medicine. So these are the interesting questions. Your personal motivation. What are your main reasons for wanting to study medicine, and why would you like to undertake medicine at UNSW? So I said, ever since year 7, when I watched the series Anatomy for Beginners by Dr. Gunther von Hagens, which I talked about before, I've been passionately interested in the biology and chemistry of the human body. Ooh. And then I start to get a little bit, how you going? Whether I do medicine post or undergrad, I'm confident I will succeed the degree and excel my potential. That doesn't even make sense. How can you excel your potential if your potential is the maximum amount of things you can do? You can't excel that. Excelling it would increase your potential and, oh, whatever. So then I just said something really generic. UNSW offers the best undergraduate medicine course. I mean, that just shows them that I don't know anything about them. If I was writing this again, I would talk about the graduate capabilities of UNSW medicine. Oh my gosh, I would like to do medicine as opposed to other bachelors. First of all, you don't say that. You say as opposed to other degrees. Because I believe I have the level of leadership and initiative to be under higher levels of pressure. Gosh, that's just cringe. So look, it's okay to talk about leadership and initiative, but I just don't like the way I worded it. And also, why the hell are none of my I's capitalized? Like, I don't think even I reread this application. So this question is about the personal characteristics you think doctors should have. I talked about the importance of sympathy and patient communication. I agree with that. And also being able to think clearly and logically in emergencies, that's fair. And they need to admit when they're wrong. Well, I agree. Okay, so that's the one question I think I agree with in my entire application. Oh, and if with all of that, they still thought that I could get through, then this was my closing statement. A quote from Dr. Zeus. And will you succeed? Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. 98.75% guaranteed. A fine quote, but has no place in your application for medicine. Oh well, let's go back to the video. So yeah, that was a pretty embarrassing application. At the same time, I was doing the UMAT, and I got a very bad first score. Scored 43rd percentile, which, you know, is just below average technically, because 50th percentile is average. But you just can't get into medicine anywhere ever with anything below 50th percentile. And you really want to try and do better. So this was the big reality check that I really needed in my life. I totally got a no. I even followed up with an email. This is one of the most cringe emails I've ever seen. And this is the worst. I urge you to give me an interview. I'm confident that I would make a brilliant medical student. Give me an interview, and if you genuinely think that I wouldn't be a great doctor or a great medical student, then I'll pay you for the time you spent interviewing me. Oh, so cringe. I'm pretty impressed that they didn't blacklist me for any future interview. So anyway, I went for medical science as an undergraduate degree with the idea that I could go into postgraduate medicine afterwards. I was pretty gung-ho on medicine. Then I did my next year, my first year of medical science. I didn't take a gap year, I went straight in, and I reapplied for medicine, did the UMAT again, got another terrible score, and failed one of the sections. And by this time was pretty disheartened and kind of reconsidering my options. But actually during that first year, I discovered there's this other entry pathway into medicine that's not undergraduate or postgraduate. It's this mixed entry thing. It's called the lateral entry pathway, and it's only done at UNSW medicine, and it's pretty bloody competitive because only 10 students per year can do it. Hey guys, just a quick interruption to give you guys a little lateral entry scheme explainer. Basically what it means is you finish your medical science degree, which is 3 years, you do an honors year, which is 4 years, then you jump in to halfway through the undergraduate medicine degree at UNSW, which means you only do half the degree, which is another 3 years. So it's 7 years all up, you do an honors year, then you graduate with a Bachelor of Medical Science with honors and a medicine degree, an MD. So by the end of the year, I knew that medicine, I could continue applying postgrad or lateral entry, but I still just needed some time away from university to kind of redevelop, or actually just develop a sense of identity, to discover the world, to reconnect with my extended family in France. I was going through a bad breakup. There was plenty of reasons to take the gap year. The reason I hear most often to not take a gap year, especially in the middle of a degree, after you've done a year and then take a year off and then go back in to defer, the reason I hear most often is, if you take the year off, you might not want to come back. Guys, that's such a good reason to take a year off. If traveling and discovering your values makes you not want to do what you're doing, then you should definitely do that, because it's suggestive that your reasoning to do what you were doing was pretty unstable, that, you know, a bit of a trip was enough to make you change your mind. So I'm very pro gap years. I understand they're not for everyone, but I had a great time during mine. I worked as a junk removalist and a truck driver and a house removalist, and then I traveled for half. So over the course of that gap year, I was convinced that medicine was what I wanted to do, for the following reasons. It was consistent with my values of, you know, having moral and ethical work. In medicine, you are always trying to help the patient. You might not always help the patient. There are times where you get complications, but you're always trying your best. Secondly, it's a valued skill. People in society value medicine. Healthcare in general is an important aspect of most societies. So it wouldn't be just working really hard and then having no kind of, I guess, societal validation for your hard work. And yes, you shouldn't think too much about how others think about your job. You should think about how you fit into your job. But having societal validation for the work that you do reinforces it long term. It's hard to do long term work if everyone thinks what you're doing is a waste of time. And three, it's a good pathway into a lot of non-clinical jobs. You can have a large impact in policy, in research, even in business. It's a really good foundation for a plethora of career opportunities. Hey guys, hope you enjoyed that. I was just watching the video and it felt like it's starting to get a bit long, so I'm gonna split it into two parts. We're gonna talk next week about that second year of medical science where I really put my head down and studied super hard. And then we're gonna talk about the UCAT, the interview, and finally, we're gonna look at that email offer, and I'll tell you guys about that moment where I actually received the email giving me an offer into UNSW Medicine. Make sure you subscribe and you tap the bell icon so that you're notified of next week's video when it comes out. So until then, have an absolutely lovely day. Bye for now.